So you've dipped your toes into the world of chromatography, and now you're interested in learning more. This video will help you learn the basics about different types of chromatography and help you decide the best approach for your application. One way to look at the different types of chromatography is by scale. On one end, you have small-scale analytical chromatography, and on the other end of the spectrum lies the larger scale of preparative chromatography. While each is a form of sample separation, there are subtle but important differences beyond just how much you want to separate at one time. In analytical chromatography, the user typically wants to identify the makeup of a sample. Perhaps you want to know the relative amount of compounds in a mixture, or maybe you just found a mystery substance and want to know its composition. Even if you only have a small amount of collected sample, you can separate it out and learn the components of that sample compound. In preparative chromatography, the goal is to produce as much of the sample output as possible so it can be used for further applications. You already know the substance you're seeking to separate out, and you want to churn out as much as you can as quickly as possible. Because of this, preparative chromatography typically requires a lot more of the initial compound when developing workflows. Let's use an analogy to explain this further. Say you're a painter and you've recently discovered a painting featuring a shade of green you've never seen before. You want to make this green yourself, but you have no idea how it was made. You wonder if it can even be made from your paint supply. You decide you must know more about this color for your next work and gather some paint flecks from the piece. You bring the paint flecks back to the studio with your analytical chromatography setup and run the separation sequence. As the chromatogram comes out, you learn its entire makeup. Eureka! The problem is, you were only able to get a few flecks of the paint, but you're going to need much more if you're going to finish your painting. The good news? You also realize that the pigment can be derived from those pesky plants that have been growing in your backyard. So, you collect a handful of the plants and bring them to your preparative chromatography setup. You load as many of the plants as possible onto the preparative column. Then, when the separation is complete, you'll be able to collect the green pigment to use in your painting. Gallery show ready in no time. With preparative chromatography, although you need more of the original sample up front, the output you receive is usable and the process is scalable. So when you decide to bring your brand new pigment to market, you'll be ready to separate without losing too much in the process. Now let's tie it all together. Put simply, if you only have a small amount of sample and just need to know something's makeup, you can use analytical chromatography to analyze the sample. On the other hand, if you want to have an output that's usable and scalable, and you have a lot of sample available, you can use preparative chromatography to separate out the desired compound. From there, you can use it for whatever application you need. Both analytical and preparative chromatography take consideration of how much compound the user wants to separate out. Other forms of chromatography can be used to answer questions regarding how to separate out different compounds. Looking to scale up your lab's purification workflow? Gilson is here to help. We specialize in preparative chromatography, and our modular components make it easy to go from pilot to production scale without needing to change systems. To learn more about what Gilson can offer you in your lab, visit the links in the description.